Welcome to Rick's Corner. I've been thinking about a lot of things with training, getting back in shape, which I'm actually getting 10 pounds back, and diet, and how to eat, and what do you eat, and what do you don't eat. There's so many factors involved here, and there's so many different types of diet, but basically they all boil down to the same thing, that it's confusing for people, because people ask me all the time. I have the younger guys come up and tell me what they're eating. I have the older guys say, what do I do? Want to get back in shape? What do I cut out of my diet? How do you do it? Is it hard? Yes, it's hard. I mean, what really works? Well, there are several ways to look at it, and there's several ways that it works. Let's just say, going back to the day of the golden era, what we did, because everybody asked about that, it was high protein, low carb. It was meat, eggs, and cottage cheese, and that was it. No fruits, maybe some vegetables, maybe a small salad with low-cal dressing. But we didn't really count calories. We didn't know what macro diets were. We didn't know how many calories a day we were getting. It wasn't really important. It was the amount of carbs that we took in. And that's what basically cut the body fat out of the diet. Now, back then I learned from many of the guys, and it was all known fact, that you don't mix carbs and fats. You have protein, you have carbs, and you have fats. So you either have protein and fats or you have protein and carbs, but you don't mix the carbs and fats together because then you end up getting fat. And you ask why? Well, because the two together store fat. You can't have them both. It just doesn't work that way. Now we had, I think first out of the box was the Atkins diet. Dr. Atkins wrote a book about the Atkins diet. It was a high protein, low carb diet. You had the Zone diet. It was a high protein, low carb diet. You had the Beverly Hills diet, it was the high protein, low carb diet, and on and on and on. Now, these diet by name with Dr. Atkins, the Zone and Beverly Hills, were fads. And the reason they were fads is because they had a name attached to it. It's like buying designer clothing. If you're gonna buy at Target, it's not as good as a designer label. You know, I mean, it's just like Ralph Lauren. You can't have both because they're both two entirely different things. However, they're the same shirt. I had a friend that manufactured clothing. And he manufactured ladies' tops, and he sold them to a very high, I think it was Giorgio in Beverly Hills. He said, Rick, I make these clothes, and I sell them to Giorgio for $3. They turn around and sell them for $300. So putting a name on something doesn't mean it's better. Putting a name on a diet doesn't mean it's better. It's just a different way of attacking it and getting people to buy your product. And let's face it, everything today is marketing. How many proteins do you see out there by companies stating that they have the best protein? There's none better. Look who endorsed my protein, a big superstar. Look who endorsed this protein, a big superstar. And 9 times out of 10, those guys don't even taste it, know what it is. They put their name on it, they get paid for it, and it's the best protein. Same with protein bars, same with protein drinks. There's some that are good, there's some aren't. I tried Muscle Milk for a standby when I need something desperately. It's good, I liked it. It worked out pretty well, but I don't live on it. Protein bars the same way, most of them are full of sugar. All right, getting back to the diet. What worked back then, people say, well, it's 40 years later or 50 years later, is that diet gonna work today for me? Well, yeah, I mean, your body didn't change in 50 years. It's still the human body. You still have the same organs. You still have the same dietary process. So basically, your body is the same body it was 50 years ago. Maybe not yours, but the human body itself. So if you put into that human body what you did 50 years ago and you work it properly, you're gonna get basically the same results. Now, there's other factors. There's age, it makes a big difference because your metabolism changes. There's the type of exercise you do, which changes what you're going to be eating and how it's going to respond. There's sleep that's involved. Do you get enough rest? Do you train hard enough? Do you overtrain? All these things enter into what kind of results you're going to get. Do you take steroids? Well, let's take that out of the equation right now because that doesn't really matter. It's basically the diet and exercise. And back in earlier days, I didn't even know about steroids. I made my best gains in a local YMCA with broken equipment, doing powerlifting and eating a lot of meat and I'm drinking a lot of milk, and I gained quick because I trained properly. All right, so the high protein, low carb diet, to me, was the best diet. Now, I gave it to some other people and it worked. I give it to my girlfriend, she says it doesn't work. However, she was eating snacks during the day and there was sugar here and there. Of course, it's not gonna work if you eat like that. You really have to stick to it. You have to stick to that diet. You cannot have carbs if you're doing the high protein, low carb diet, and you're just having fats. Now, fats are burned as energy. Everybody says, oh, I eat egg whites. Egg whites became popular as a trend. I gotta have egg whites. Every menu has egg whites. The yolk's the best part of the egg. It has all the nutrients. It has the fat that you use for energy and also burns cholesterol as well. A lot of people don't know that, but a lot of people do. My cardiologist knew the same thing. He told me, you're right, Rick. The yolk is beneficial. All right, that's part of your fat that you use for energy. So if you have the eggs and the meat and the cottage cheese and this has a little fat in it. This is where you're going to get your energy from. People said to me, how did you train so hard without carbs? Didn't you run out of gas? No. The fats helped. The fats really helped. Okay. 1 year I switched that. I decided, okay, let's do this. Let's do fish all year and rice and vegetables, and let's don't have any fats at all. I cut all my fats out. I had the same results as I had with the other diet because I wasn't getting any carbs. I mean, I was getting carbs. No, I was getting the fish and the rice, which are carbs, and I wasn't getting any fats. So cutting the fats out, I was able to have the carbs, but I didn't store them as fat. I used them as energy. So I didn't have two. I had just the opposite. And I really got lean on that, especially the fish, not eating meat every day. I got really lean and hard. So that diet worked too. And both diets, you have to drink a lot of water. You have to flush your system. And this is how it happens. Many people come to the gym in the morning. I see them, did you have breakfast? Nope, I don't eat till like 3 in the afternoon. Wrong. You've got to eat. You got to have fuel. You got to keep the metabolism burning. We were talking last night at my girlfriend's house about a Jenny Craig or one of those diets, the Weight Watchers diet, how they portion food out for people who can't lose weight. I had a student that was wrestling. He was in his late 50s, and he lost like 60 pounds on that diet, on the Weight Watchers. He had portion food, and he only ate certain amounts certain times a day. Yes, he lost 50 pounds, but he didn't have any muscle. He just lost body fat and some muscle along with it. Just lost weight, period. Different type of diet, because you can eat anything you want on that diet. Then he decided to start training at Gold's Gym. Then he started to do high protein, low carb, and then he got really in good shape. So those two diets were completely opposite. One knocked the weight off originally, but this one knocked the fat off at the second time he tried to do it. So my feelings are, I don't know, I'm still old school, and old school was best as far as I'm concerned. And I see today's trainers training people like I talked about with balls and doing all these weird exercises. They don't even tell them what to eat. I asked several clients of trainers, do you have a meal plan? No, my trainer never told me how to eat. And I look at the trainers and obviously they don't know either. They're skinny little buggy whip arms with skinny pencil necks and they don't even know what they're doing. So diet is 80% of it, and they need to have someone control their diet and tell them how to eat properly. Now, if you want to try this, and you guys all know this, you have to eat protein. You have to have, I believe it's 1 gram for every pound of body weight. So if I'm 200 pounds, I have 200 grams of protein a day. And I divide those up throughout the day by five. So at least I have it five times a day in different intervals. This is what feeds the muscle. This is what makes the muscle grow. Having the fats along with it gives me the energy to move around and to think and be able to work out and do stuff. And then sleep at night, 7-8 hours is what I get normally. I sleep good and I rebuild. Now, at my age, it's a little bit more difficult, especially coming out of the hospital like I did, to gain what I want back. I gained 10 pounds back. I feel like I'm back where I want to be, but I still feel a little lag because it takes several months to have your body go through such trauma to come back again. But the diet really helped me come back. This diet brought me back along with the training. So I'm convinced that it's the same thing I did 50 years ago, and it's working for me now, and it worked for me then. So my advice to all of you is you find what works for you. I'm not telling you all to do the same thing because the doctor doesn't give everybody the same medicine because there's different reasons for what you do. Your body may respond well on a high protein, low carb. It may not. It depends on you. It depends on how you do it. Depends on how you train. Depends on how you sleep. How many reps you do. How much weight you use. All that figures into it. But we're not talking about that now. We're talking about the diet. The high protein, no fat diet, and eating the carbs with rice might work for you just as well. I say take a month and try one, take a month and try the other. See what works best for you. Now, when you do the high protein with the carbs, you can have rice, you can have fruit, you can have those satisfying things that make you feel like you're satisfying your hunger. You're just eliminating the fats. And you have to look at what fats are and make a list and just take those out of your diet. Now, if you're going to do the protein and the fats, the good fats, list the fats you're going to eat and take all the carbs and take those out of your diet. And I tell people, if it's carbs, it's if anything white, don't eat it. Don't eat white rice, white bread, white flour, white sugar, on down the line. Eliminate that. I had a friend that got rid of Cokes. He was drinking Cokes every day. He got rid of it. He lost 50 pounds. Just like that. Just getting rid of the sugar. So for bodybuilding, the whole key is what you want to do is to have lean muscle mass. You don't want to be bulky and thick and full of fluid and look puffy. That's the worst thing to look like. And you take your shirt off, you look like a Pillsbury Doughboy. I'm serious. I've seen so much of this in the gym with the younger guys and them pimples all over the back from taking testosterone and all that. You want to look good. You want to look like an athlete. And some of these guys today in the fitness modeling, they go up there on stage and they're doing physique. They look fantastic. I mean, these guys look great. They're lean. They're hard. They got abs. They got muscular. That's the look people like. That is what people want to see. It's not this big overgrown bodybuilding thing that today has completely gotten out of hand. It looks like elephants on stage. And they're eating tremendous amounts of food all day long and tremendous amount of drugs. So if you want to stay drug-free and you want to train hard and you want to eat right, try that diet. Either do the high-protein, low-carb or the high-protein, low-fat or no-fat. See how that works for you. I'm not saying that, like I said, not this doesn't work for everybody until you find your niche. But if you experiment with it and you try it, then you'll know what works for you. But give it a good month. Give it 6 weeks. See how your body responds. The scale isn't the most important thing in the world. It's the mirror. If you look in the mirror and you see something that looks good to you, you know you're on the right track. If your clothes fit you well, you know you're on the right track. So that's my advice on dieting and how to get across the board and where you want to feel good and look good. And my thing is to experiment and try it and let me know and write on comments how it's working for you and ask any questions that you want because I'm willing to answer it. But over my 50 years of experience, I've seen this happen. And I've seen the guys that I trained with, like Bill Grant, Arnold, Ken Waller, all these guys back in the day, man, they cut their carbs down to zero. And then afterwards, they go to the House of Pies a week later after a contest and blew up like a balloon. And one guy gained, a friend of mine gained 30 pounds in one weekend, just edema, just water from putting weight back on. That was kind of funny to see that. Anyway, that's my deal on the diet. Thank you for watching Rick's Corner, and I'll be back next week with new stuff. And be sure you can order one of my hand-drawn logos for Gold's Gym and autograph to you. It's on my website, $75, and you can frame it, put it on your wall. Who knows? It might become a huge collector's item one day when I'm not here anymore. So take a look at that, and we'll talk to you later. Bye-bye. See you soon.
RickTrayson.com. He is the equalizer, baby. See you next time.